Hi and what's up everybody? Thank you so much for tuning in, and if you're new here, make sure to subscribe and also turn on those notifications to be updated about my new videos, because I post 5 times a week. And in today's one, I will review long-awaited and recently launched fragrance by Lancôme that is called Idole, and the face of this new perfume is Zendaya, and I find she was picked perfectly because she's young and thin, and the bottle of this perfume is actually what made me so excited about it, not the fragrance, because I knew how it will smell and we'll get to it a little bit later, but the bottle is actually what is worth attention, because it is ultra thin and it is pink, it looks innovative and stands out from everything else. The only problem with the packaging is that it is not very handy, it can lay or it can stand in a holder, so keep that in mind. How does Idole smell? It is a simple, generic, floral musky fragrance with abstract, synthetic rose accord in there. Actually, rose is not bad, but not good in there. It's almost like an imitation of a rose. It is a little bit clean, it has decent amounts of sweetness, and I find it is amazing for younger audience. That's why Zendaya was the perfect choice for the advertisement of Idole. So I wore it to work a few times and I enjoyed it very much, because it is light, it makes you to fit in, please your colleagues, get a few compliments. But the problem is it is not very long lasting, and even though I even went to the shop and sprayed it 6 times on me, after around 30 minutes, it disappears. Maybe that's only my problem. Let me know if you have any issues with the longevity as well. But Idole is a lovely new release that doesn't smell new at all. So if you're expecting the fragrance to be such innovative as the packaging, don't expect that. But yeah, it's nice if you want something simple and something that won't make you to stand out from the crowd, but just, you know, be lovely, girly and very modern, because it is a modern release. And I wanted to compare it to other modern smelling perfumes such as Chanel's Gabrielle Eau de Parfum, and when it first came out I wasn't impressed by it because I thought it misses some character, but now I can appreciate it so much more. And what I love about Gabrielle is its fantastic sparkling opening of zesty grapefruit that smells citrusy and very fresh, and later on the fragrance develops as floral musky fragrance, but it is clean, it is crisp, and it is definitely as recognizable as other Chanel's perfumes. Think about Chanel No. 5, Coco Mademoiselle, and even Chanel Chance, but this one is created for younger audience who want to smell very classy, luxurious and modern. So the third fragrance that I wanted to throw in this list is Joy by Dior, that I first hated when it came out because it smelled like shower gel to me, and I tested it a few times on my skin and on the blotter, and as I was getting ready for this video I gave it another chance and I was rewarded because I noticed something so beautifully powdery in the dry down that reminded me of peach skin. So Joy is definitely sweeter than Gabrielle and Idole. It has this fruity juiciness to it and it is quite powdery and floral as well. So maybe if you want something trendy with a juicy sweet twist, that is Joy. If you prefer more clean, crisp and classy smelling perfumes, that is Gabrielle. And if you want something very light, a little bit clean, a little bit synthetic, but I don't know if someone wants something synthetic and rosy, that is Idole. You can definitely give all these three fragrances a chance and let me know which of them you prefer, but I'm particularly interested in your opinion on Idole, so definitely share it with all of us in the comments, as well as let me know what you think about this video and which of designer feminine perfumes you want me to review next. By the way, I prepared something interesting for next week, so stay tuned for it. Make sure to like this video if you enjoyed and found it helpful. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and in the description box down below you will find a link to my review on Joy and Gabrielle if you want more information about them. I'm looking forward to hear from you, and thank you so much for watching. again, and stay tuned. And if you want something very trendy, give these fragrances a try. And if you know some other very trendy perfumes that you like and you want to share with me and my subscribers, feel free to share. So yeah, stay tuned, smell good. We'll see each other next time really soon. Bye guys.